Do you want to ring the bell?
Seiler? Oh Gott, oh Gott. Und Ben?
Silke Orfall and Ilona Seber are at the door of their old building in East Berlin. They lived here when they were young, a life that was anything but private. Stasi informers spied on them from across the courtyard, back when this tree was much smaller. Did you see Stasi people standing there?
Nee.
No, I just found out when I read about it. We would never have thought about it. The thought of them standing there, no. Their Stasi files contain hundreds of pages, intercepted letters and informers' reports, including Seber and Orfall's apartment layout. Observation recorded April 30th, 1980 at 7 o'clock. A light was on in the kitchen and the window was half open. Roughly 50 minutes later, the light went out and Seber left the apartment alone. She headed on foot in the direction of the Samariter Street subway. Someone looked into my life and I had no idea. They described me as a person from their perspective, which wasn't a very friendly one. It's there, but I live with it. In my experience, you get through life just as well, or even better, when you adjust to a situation. But why were the two women spied on in their youth? They came from the provinces to East Berlin and found good jobs here working for the East German state newspaper Neues Deutschland, or New Germany. But they made a fateful move. They tried to leave the country. From 1976 onwards, Silke Orfall and Ilona Seber applied again and again to leave, always giving the same reason. I do not believe the trustworthiness of this government. I have seen firsthand how little human rights are respected in East Germany. These days, they tell people born after the wall came down how they risked life and limb to leave East Germany. I didn't want someone else to decide where I lived. At a certain point, I had enough. And then I thought, well, no, I want out. I want freedom. And for that desire, they almost ended up in prison.